Do you know what it's like to pick up a property for $10,000? It doesn't matter if you know what it's like to pick up a property for $10,000, because I'm going to tell you. This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS, and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world. Welcome to the MLS Search and Analysis Show. My name is James Wise. I am the guy that is going to be hitting you with real estate knowledge and occasionally a wrestling impression. And that's cool. Why? Because this motherfucker, Charlie from Miami, he fucking loves it. He fucking loves wrestling and real estate. And if I had to guess, probably big titties. Because who doesn't, right? Charlie, my man, you reached out to us because you want to buy some cheap real estate. And you want to do it from somebody who also loves watching jabronis get their asses kicked. Monday nights, Friday nights, Wednesday nights. Friday nights after 10. There's a lot of wrestling shows on out there, folks. There's a lot of wrestling shows. All right, and Charlie, you watch them all, as do I. Who doesn't, right? And what you want to do besides talk shop about wrestling, brother, is you want to do some deals in the 20 or 30K range, okay? And as I said at the top, in my Dwayne voice, it doesn't matter if you know what it's like to invest in properties that only require 10K, because I'm going to tell you what it's like. I'm going to give you the ins, the outs, the pros, the cons, the goods, the bads. I'm going to break the whole thing down to you, right? That's my job. Part of my job is to find you properties. But the other part of my job is to teach you what it's like when you buy those properties. And then lastly, the last part of my job is to let you know what is and is not possible. Now, I'm going to show you a property, brother, that you could pick up with $10,000 cash if it goes the way I want it to. Okay, but here's the kicker to that. It's not 10K as in you buy the house for 10K. The house is going to cost more. You're only going to need 10K in cash. We'll get you a lender for the other amount of money. So if you're wondering if you can do properties for 20 or 30K, yes, if those are your down payments. No, if you're looking to be all in as it's a $30,000 cash price. That's not doable. This one is going to be as close to that as we can hit. This one, if it goes how I want it to go, should be an all-in purchase price of $40,000, and only $10,000 of that needs to come out of your pocket. Not all of it's good. Some of it's bad. There is always going to be risks, and there's always going to be rewards, right? Like, you know, when Hulk Hogan went from face to heel, right? The pros, he got a whole bunch of adult fans. The cons, little kids didn't buy his shirts as much anymore, right? It's not family-friendly for your 9-year-old when Hollywood Hulk Hogan is hitting motherfuckers in the head with a chair and then spray-painting all over their back, right? That's not brush your teeth, say your prayers kind of stuff like, you know, back in the early run of his career, right? You got to take the good with the bad, man. You pick up new fans, you lose some old fans, right? So when you invest in real estate, you invest in the really, really cheap stuff, you're going to get a lot of pros. But there are going to be some issues that come along with it, and I will do my very best to make you aware of those right after this.
Steve, what are you doing?
Oh, nothing. Just saving money on my rental property insurance.
Oh my, Steve. Take me now.
Holton-Wise, real estate investing made easy.
Wow, I'm so glad I clicked that link below.
Welcome back. Let's get into the meat, right? We got to see how the sausage is made, right? If you're going to pick up real estate, low-cost real estate, you have to understand the pros and the cons, the good and the bad. You have to understand what you're getting yourself into. 2119 Washington Ave, Lorain, Ohio, 44052, priced at $50,500. But I do not want you to pay $50,500. I want you to pay $40,000. $40,000 is what I believe I can secure this deal for you, all right? It's been on the market for 7 days, okay? And I believe it's been on the market for 7 days at a very low price because they have a couple issues with the listing and with selling the property, right? Now, I'm not saying those issues are the property itself or even the fault of the seller. It's just the situation that they're in. You see, when you have a house, folks, there's two kinds of people that can buy houses, okay? The two kinds of people that can buy houses are either going to be people that want to live in those houses, right? People with their family. They need a place to live. That's what a fucking house is, right? It's a place to live, right? That's one kind of person. The second is you, investors. Investors looking for cash flow, right? So if you take half the buyers that could possibly buy your product, being those people that want to live in the house, and you get rid of them, that's going to beat your price down, right? The reason those people can't buy this house is because there's already a tenant in there, right? Thus making it more appealing to you guys, right? The rental property investors, the people that work with me, the people that buy shows on the Holton-Wise MLS search and analysis show, right? The people watching Holton-Wise TV are the people that want tenants, right? Because y'all ain't going to live in there. You're looking for a cash flow investment, right? But it's not super appealing to you guys either, right? Two reasons for that. Number one, you can't do as much due diligence and research up front as you would typically like to do. This is the only photograph we have been provided for by the listing agent. And it does not paint the home in the greatest scenario, right? This fucking grass doesn't look like it's been cut in two motherfucking weeks. We got fucking blankets on the fucking windows. We got a little bit of peeling paint. I mean, the thing just, nothing screams like, oh, this is awesome, right? Nothing screams that. And then there's no other pictures, no other pictures to allow you to continue to go in and do your due diligence. The reason there's no pictures, because tenants don't like motherfuckers coming in their houses, guys, right? It's just how it is, right? That's the business, okay? They don't want a bunch of people bothering them, right? They've always been like that. When you're working in C, D grade neighborhoods, that's the name of the game. That's what you're jumping into. That's the business you're getting in. If that's a problem for you, if you think that your tenants should be like, oh, there's the landlord. He's so fucking cool. Hey, come on in. My wife made cookies for you, bro. If you're anticipating that to be how the business is, motherfucker, you in the wrong motherfucking business, bro. Pack up shop, close your fucking iPhone, go invest in Bitcoin, dude, because real estate investing, it's going to kick you in the fucking dick, all right? That's not for you, dog. On top of that, since it's always been like that, we ran into COVID, right? COVID, Jesus Christ. The people that don't want motherfuckers coming in their houses before, those motherfuckers really don't want you guys in there now, right? So listing agents, a lot of the listing agents that do deals, right? Most real estate agents, folks, they work with people, the other kind of buyer, the kind of people that want to buy houses to live in them, right? Maybe the current owner of this property acquired the property randomly, thought he's going to be a landlord, didn't like it. Now he wants to sell it. So what does he do? He hires the realtor that sold him and his family their, you know, fancy little house with the white picket fence, right? That's how it works a lot of times. A lot of realtors, they don't understand the rental business. The seller probably doesn't understand the rental business. And, you know, it's just not marketed properly, and the tenants are fighting you every step of the way. All that means for everyone is that's how we get properties like this on the market for $50,500 that are going to show $1,000 a month market rent. And that's how they're still on the market a week later and how I believe I can get you $10,000 off because I know how to work through all these issues, right? That's all I do, dude. I don't sell people houses for them to live in, right? If you're like a family in the Cleveland market and you're like, hey, man, we want to buy a $500,000 house in the suburbs with a cul-de-sac. Like, you want to drive around and look at houses on Sunday? Fuck no, motherfucker! You know how many open houses I've done in my life? Like, fucking one. And it was fucking horrible. And, like, I was like, dude, fuck this, right? Like, there's this other realtor chick there. It was her open house. I was the broker. At one point, we were doing a little bit of residential work, and we had agents working for us, and, like, she's fucking baking cookies, and motherfuckers are talking to me about fucking kids' soccer teams and fucking design and paint colors. Jesus Christ, it's not my game, man. It's not what I do. 99.5% of the realtors in this market, that's their game. Let them do that. But what we do, folks, what we do is we turn things like this into money. That is my game. That's what I love to do, right? So here are my thoughts. Market rent, 1,000, right? 12K a year, Section 8 tenant, all day, baby. That's what we do at Holton Wise. Now, you don't get to keep that 1,000, people, right? You don't get to keep that, okay? Every month, the average cost estimate between your fixed and variable expense estimates is going to be almost half. It's going to be $459.40. That's not $459.40 every month, right? That's calculating in the long-term performance, right? Leaving you with an NOI of $540.60 a month, or just shy of $6,500 for the year. You buy it at the price I want you to buy it at, $40K. You put up $10, bank puts up $30. That projects out to a 50% cash-on-cash return, or a 16.2 cap. But, hold on. Hold the phone before you get too excited. The reason I told you that this wasn't going to appeal to you guys is more than just the fact that there's no pictures, okay? Even if there's no pictures, if something's kicking off a 50% return, right? There's still going to be a high demand for it, right? We ain't there yet, right? One issue we have is the current tenant that's in there, right? The tenant that don't want none of y'all motherfuckers bothering them. They're paying $650 a month plus utilities, so they're paying $7.25, right? Now, they're paying their $650, plus they're paying gas, electric, water. We have you guys as landlords pay the water just based on how the laws work out here in the water departments. I don't feel like burning a lot of time in this video on why that is. It blows people's minds. So instead, I've created a FAQ on HoltonWise.com. Check that out. I explain all of that, right? Because if you saw in the chart, I had a line item for you paying the water sewer. It's a whole long story, but you got to pay the water and sewer. That's just how it's going to be, right? So basically right now, current seller, mom and pop landlord, probably not a professional in the business. They're getting $7.25. Doesn't look as appealing as that $1,000, right? I know through having sold $200 million of investments just like this that this is really a $1,000 rental. But we don't get to just go from $7.25 to $1,000 like that. It's not how it works, right? We don't want to just take over the property and be like, hey, Mr. Tenant, your rent's now $1,000. Thank you very much, right? They're probably going to move out if you do that. You don't want them to move out because I can almost guarantee you that there is no scenario where this doesn't need a full turnover on the inside. When somebody's been living there a long time, below market rent, and then they move out, you don't just get to broom. You don't get to broom sweep the living room, throw some Febreze in the bathroom, and then move new tenants in at $1,000. That's why it's not a big deal to me that we don't have the photos right now, because I know, just looking at this, just looking at the outside, looking at the grass should tell you this is not going to be brand fucking new when you move in. When these people move out, you're going to have to repaint the walls, probably repaint the counter, the cabinets in the kitchen, probably put in new fixtures in the bathroom, probably replace any carpet that's in there, right? Probably a $10,000, $15,000 turn to get it mint, to get it ready for Section 8, right? I know that that's what you're going to get, right? There's almost no scenario where you won't. Now, we're going to do more due diligence before you actually buy it, right? We're going to have you do a third-party home inspection. Take a look at the big-ticket items, the roof, the furnace, the hot water tank, things of that nature, the big-ticket items. I could tell you right now, none of them are going to be new, man. If you're anticipating buying a property for $40K and then the report comes back and the furnace isn't brand new and you're like, oh, hey, James, the furnace ain't new. Can we get $3,000 off? No, motherfucker! Why do you think it was fucking $40,000? It's not like, oh, $40,000 house, but the furnace isn't brand new. It must be a $37,000 house. No! Use your brains. You're going to be getting an old furnace. You're going to be getting an old hot water tank. You're going to be getting an older roof, right? You're probably going to have between 5 and 10 years left of life on all of those items, right? Roofs, they last 30 years. That's a $7,000 roof. Furnaces, 30 years. Furnaces are $3,000. Hot water tanks last 15 years. They're $1,000. You're getting, you know, a living, breathing, kind of worn down rental property, right? That's going to make some money. But no, you ain't getting something that's like perfect, okay? We're going to do the due diligence, get the inspection report so we know exactly what we're getting. If there's something out of the ordinary that makes this not worth $40K like other homes in the neighborhood, right, I will let you know. But otherwise, don't anticipate anything being brand new. If you want it to be like super brand new and stuff, like, you know, throw in another like $40,000 on top of this and we'll get you something, right? But if you're trying to be in this price point, set your expectations properly, right? You're going to be getting, you know, kind of an older property, and you're going to be getting a below-market tenant, and that's why we don't want to jack their rent up, right? We want that tenant to stay in there as long as we can keep them in there, increase their rent slowly so we can get them as close to that $1,000 a month as possible without creating an artificial turnover, which creates artificial renovations. In the rental business, folks, people are going to move out of your properties. They don't live there forever. I wish they did. But they don't. That's just the name of the game. So if you're a smart landlord, you don't do more renovations than you need to do. You're going to have the opportunity to do a turnover when this person naturally moves out. At that point, we're going to make it look legit, and we're going to slap a Section 8 tenant in there, and you're going to be at 1,000. Until then, let's keep collecting that money as it comes in and try to slowly increase the amount of money as it comes in, right? That's the smartest way to do it. And I'm not doing that to be like, Mr. Bleeding Heart over here, let's not put this tenant out. I'm not thinking like that. I'm thinking about you. I'm thinking about your bottom line. It just doesn't make sense for you to say, no, I don't want that money. Let me throw another $15K at it right now. No, that does not make sense. Collect the money as it comes in, and then when the turnover naturally occurs, then you do the investment.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to Holton-Wise TV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.